Hi, this is JP Morgan. Today on the Slanted Lens, we're going to walk you through the process that we use to batch process raw images and then to create time-lapse sequences in QuickTime. We'll also talk about how to deflicker your images when you shoot on Aperture Preferred. So let's go ahead and get started and see what we can do. Okay, first off, I'm going to put all of my raw images in a folder. I then am going to open that up in Bridge. In Bridge, I'm going to go to File, Open in Camera Raw, and open up all these images. Now this is like 400 or 500 images we're opening up here at once. So we're going to load all of those images into Camera Raw. I'm now going to go over and just process the first image. Now sometimes you may not want to do the first image, you may want to go a little later, do one of the later images because you're going to have a lot of blue in the first one from the sun going down in the blue sky. So we'll start off with our exposure. I'm going to open up the exposure a little bit to about plus 60. Then I'm going to mess with the contrast. I may push the contrast up just a little bit to about plus 10. Now I'm going to push the whites up to about 45. I'm going to push them up pretty far. I'm going to open up the shadows just a little bit. So I'll push the shadows back and kind of end up being somewhere around, oh, I don't know, that looks fairly good. Let's say about 25 or 26. Now our highlights, we're going to go back. We're going to open them up to plus about 13 or 14 is going to look nice. Our blacks, we don't want to darken the blacks too much, so we're going to just a little bit of like about 5 or 6, just to give us a little bit of contrast there, so about plus 6. Now I like the clarity a lot, so I'm going to push that up because it makes the clouds a little more sharp, makes the image in the foreground a little more sharp, so I'm going to push that up pretty high, somewhere in the 30 to 40 range. You know, I probably won't mess very much with the vibrance or saturation. I may push the vibrance up just a tiny bit, maybe plus 5 or 6, just to give a little bit of color vibrance, and I'll leave the saturation alone. At that point, I hit select all, and I synchronize. And when I synchronize, it's going to synchronize all those images to that first image that I processed. And once I've done that, I'm going to save my images. I'm going to go back to the same folder. I'm going to select a folder. There we go, subfolder called processed in my time-lapse. And I'll select that, and then I'm going to want to make an extension of JPEG, and I want to make a maximum of 12, so it's as large as possible. I want to move all the metadata, so I just hit save, and now it'll start to process those. It's going to take a little while, so I'm going to want to go out and do something else. I'll get that started and come back to it after a while. Now that I've processed my images, I'm going to turn them into time-lapse video. There are a couple of different ways to do this, but I prefer to do it in QuickTime. It's just easy and quick to do. First off, I'm going to go up to in QuickTime to Open Image Sequence. When I click on Open Image Sequence, it's going to bring a dialog box up. I'm going to go to the images that I processed. So I'll go to my time-lapse, Milky Way time-lapse 1. It's the first one I'm doing. At the very bottom, I've got my process folder. I'll click on that. I'll click on the first image at the very top of my processed folder, and I'll hit Open. Now here, I can choose the number of frames per second. I'm going to choose around 24 frames a second. If the time lapse is a little slow, I could choose 60 frames a second to speed it up. Now when I come up, I'm going to get this large image. It's a very large, full-framed image. I'm going to go into the view, and I'm going to bring this back to a fit screen size so I can see the information in front of me. Now I'm going to go up to File, Export. So I'm going to export this a movie to QuickTime Movie, and I'm going to save it, create a new folder called Final Outputs, not with a large U, but with a little U. There we go. I'm going to call this Milky Way number 1. And hit save. Now this is going to take a while. It's going to go into an export phase, which may take 20, 30 minutes. Maybe not quite that long, but it'll take quite a while to export it, and then we'll have our final MLB file.
We shot on manual exposure, but if you're going to try tracking sunset into stars at night, you're going to have to use Aperture Preferred and let the shutter drag. In doing that, a little bit of flicker is going to be present in your final piece. To clean this up, we use a deflickering software. There are many of them out there, but the one I use that I like the most is called Granite Bay. This has been a lot of fun to go out to Mona Lake and to be able to put together these time-lapse pieces. My goal in this was to get all the information together in 2 lessons that'll give you the information you need to be able to shoot, the stars, find the Milky Way, be able to expose at night, and then all the post-process to be able to put your time-lapse together. So I hope you found this valuable, so keep those cameras rolling, keep on clicking.